have the 25th annual Putnam County Spelling Bee. We grew up undeniably, and look, our hair is thinning. Our past caught up to us at last. It was a very nice, very nice, very, very, very nice, very nice, very nice, very, very, very nice, very nice beginning.
Oh, hello, everyone. Don't you look nice?
Miss Peretti, please spell syzygy.
Syzygy. S-Y-Z-Y-G-Y. Syzygy.
We have a winner!
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
At the 25th annual Putnam County Spelling Bee, my parents keep on telling me that being here is winning, although I know it isn't so.
But it's a very nice, very, very nice, very, very nice, very nice beginning. Oh, our winner here last year, Chip Tolentino.
Hello. Oh, this is Freddy!
Oh, and our youngest competitor, Logan Schwartz and Grubenier.
Oh. Annual Putnam County Spelling Game. B, I'll stand when they announce my name.
Leaf Coney Bear.
And try to keep from shaking.
Unless he's shaking, will not pass.
Cause it's a very big, very fraught, simple, but it's not. It's a very big undertaking.
Returning after last season's tragic setback, William Barfy.
It's pronounced Barfay. There's an accent ague.
Oh, I don't know who that girl is.
Marcy Park, recent transfer.
Winner's destination, Washington, D.C.
Plasma TV and a fancy hotel where they treat you well. All because you love to spell. We spell.
Marvelous memory. If you win the spelling bee, one's life improves from A to Z. The minute you are crowned here, I see a trophy held by me. And when I won, did I swell all the stories I could tell? But braggarts don't do well around here.
Hi, I'm Oliver Strong.
Excuse me, I just marked this face off with invisible tape.
Oh, sorry.
At the 25th annual,
we memorized the manual about how to spell these words. Words that require thought. People think we're automatons, but that is exactly what we're not. Unlike idiots, we ideate.
To ideate is to form an image or idea.
At the 25th annual Putnam County Spelling Bee,
we feel no animosity, and yet our heads are spinning.
We are the slightest bit bizarre.
But since the time is now,
holy cow,
we shall take a thumb, about to concentrate on winning.
We concentrate on winning. At the 25th annual Putnam County Spelling Bee, we speak so darn convincingly.
They're nervous, but they're grinning.
It seems we're living out our dreams.
Very nice, very nice, very, very, very nice.
gentlemen. So nice to see you all. I do have a few brief announcements. Please turn off all cell phones and other distracting devices. You know who you are. And no photos at the bee. Oh, and I do have some announcements about our wonderful backup band and singers. We have the Putnam Valley High School Pep Band and the Singing Bees. Now, let's see. We seem to be missing a few of our spellers. Let's see. When I call your name, please come to the stage and meet me at the desk for your number. Kim Kazaki. Oh. Wonderful. Chris Wolf. Eric Porter.
Why are so many people?
And Daniel Urbanski. Thank you. Watch your step.
It's not nice to be late. It's not very late to be late, especially when you're spelling.
Right, here we are. Hello there. Welcome. This young man will show you the way. Thank you. Wonderful. Hello there. How are you?
Come here, sir. Oh, come with me.
Follow this gentleman. Yes. Thank you. Well, hello there.
Hi. I'm Olive. I like you.
President.
Hey, buddy. You can come sit over here.
Hi.
And they're all smiling this way. You may come this way. Come on. Go.
Very nice to me.
Okay.
Oh. Actually, could you two switch?
Strofsky, please.
I'm Olive.
Oh, good. Come here, dear.
Actually, will you sit right there? No, you don't sit there. You sit down there.
Wonderful. Everybody situated?
Quicksilver.
Olive, dear, did no one at your school mention the $25 entrance fee?
Entrance fee?
Oh, dear. Well, how did you get to the beach? I wonder if your mom or dad are here, perhaps.
Well, my dad got called into work, but he said he's going to try to come later.
Oh, well, how did you get to the bee, dear?
The bus.
Oh, I see. Well, all right, dear. Have a seat, and we'll talk about it later. Thank you. Wonderful.
Hi, I'm Olive.
Hey, I like your shirt and your shorts. Hey, Marcy! Hey, Marcy! Hey, Marcy! Hey, Marcy!
What?
Don't be nervous. Just do what I do.
Don't worry. I'm not nervous.
Hey, why are you holding your breath like that?
It helps me focus. So what school do you go to?
Shut up.
Oh. Have you ever been in a gymnasium before? They used to be a bowling alley and has stage lights.
I've never been in a gymnasium before.
All right, dears, take your seats, please. Thank you. Oh, dear. Leaf, hello. Back to Earth, dear. Thank you. Oh, dear. Well, ladies and gentlemen, all of the children you see here on our stage are here because of their extraordinary ability and love of language.
Love of language.
But only one of them can go on to compete in the National Bee. Ooh. And this year, to celebrate our silver anniversary, our local sponsors, the Putnam Optometrist, are offering today's winner a $200 savings bond towards their future education.
Whoa! Wonderful. Awesome.
Yes. But remember, to get here, each child had to win.
Oh, but I...
Or place, Leaf, in their own District B. So each of them is already a winner.
Already a winner.
Hello, I am Rona Lisa Peretti, and I am thrilled to be hosting my 9th consecutive B. Unfortunately, oh, thank you, dear. You're right to clap, thank you. Unfortunately, our usual word pronouncer, Superintendent Spriggs, was detained as he is at a tea party with Sarah Palin. So, instead, we are delighted to have coming back with us today Vice Principal Douglas Ponch, who is returning to us from Dos Passos Junior High School after a 5-year hiatus. Please give him a hand. It was such short notice. Thank you.
Thank you, Rona. And as to the little incident 5 years ago, well, I just wanted to say that I'm in a much better place now. It's amazing what a diet can do for a man.
Oh, wonderful.
Oh, and may I add that not only is Miss Peretti here one of Putnam County's top realtors, she's also a former Spelling Bee champion herself.
third annual
Syzygy.
Syzygy. When the earth aligns with the moon and the sun.
Beautiful. Yeah. Okay, well, why don't we all stand for the Pledge of Allegiance, led by our comfort counselor, Mr. Mitchell M. Mahoney.
Mr. Mahoney is here today serving his community service hours.
I pledge allegiance
to the United States of America and to the Republic. All right then, spellers, please be seated. Thank you, Mitch.
And now for the official spelling bee rules.
A speller.
A speller.
May ask questions.
May ask questions.
About the words pronunciation or definition.
Definition.
Its use in a sentence.
In a sentence.
And its language of origin.
Language of origin.
If you start to spell a word, you may start over.
But the sequences of letters already spoken may not be changed.
If you miss spell a word.
Misspell a word.
We will ring, the bell. And the comfort counselor.
Mitch Mahoney.
Mitch Mahoney!
We'll escort you off stage.
Is that understood, spellers?
Yes.
Before anyone is disqualified and before proceedings turn snide and contestants turn nasty, I soberly confide in the moment before the bee claims its first catastrophe. I love what I see, kids acting innocently.
Without further ado, let the spelling begin with Miss Schwartzengrubenier.
Miss Schwartzengrubenier is the head of her school's Gay Straight Alliance at the elementary school.
Strabismus.
Strabismus. May I have the definition, please?
The inability of one eye to obtain binocular vision with the other because of an imbalance of the muscles of the eyeball.
And use in a sentence, please.
In the schoolyard, Billy protested that he wasn't cockeyed. I suffer from strabismus, he said, whereupon the bullies beat him harder.
Strabismus.
Notice how she writes on her forearm. This is her way to see the word first before she speaks it out loud.
Strabismus. S-T-R-A-B-I-S-M-U-S. Strabismus.
That is correct. Mr. Coney Bear.
Mr. Coney Bear was second runner-up in the Putnam Basin District.
Brooke, will you please tell Leaf he has a phone call?
Leaf! Phone!
Thanks, I got it. Thanks. Hello? Leaf speaking.
Uh-huh. 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 You're kidding! I'm gonna represent the basin in the bee? Wow, I can't believe it! Mom! Dad! Marigold! Brook! Pinecone! Raisin! Landscape! Paul! You're not gonna believe this.
What's up, Leaf?
I made the county finals in the spelling bee.
Oh, sweetheart. No, honey. You came in third.
I know, but they just called and said the person who came in first has to go to their bat mitzvah, and the person who came in second has to attend that bat mitzvah. So they want me to do it.
You know all the other students will have won their districts, right?
Capybara.
What?
Your word is capybara.
Is that a word?
That is a word, yes.
No way. What's it mean?
A tailless, largely aquatic, South American rodent, often exceeding 4 feet in length.
Awesome! What else can I ask?
You're allowed to ask for the word's language of origin or to have it used in a sentence.
Oh. Could you use it in a sentence?
Don't look now, Pedro. But I think that tailless, largely aquatic, 4.5-foot mammal swimming next to you may indeed be a capybara.
Wow, that didn't help at all.
Are you ready to spell the word, Mr. Coney Bear?
No. But it was fun to come here. Hi, guys. My whole family's here tonight, which is really C-A-P-Y-B-A-R-A. Capybara?
That is correct.
It is? Guys, I got the word right!
That
was unbelievable. I didn't even know what I was doing.
Miss Ostrovsky.
Miss Ostrovsky came in second in her school's Halloween contest.
I was roadkill.
Boanthropy.
Boanthropy. May I have a definition?
The delusion that one has become an ox.
Excuse me, ma'am, yes. Could you not sit in that seat?
I saved a chair for my dad in the fourth row on the aisle. And it may take him a while, but when he gets here, that's his chair. 'Cause my mother's in an ashram in India. I saved a chair for her too, but it's merely symbolic, as daily she cleanses herself in the Ganges. And I live in a house where there's an oversized dictionary that I read as a girl on the toilet.
Boanthropy.
Does that have the Latin root bo meaning ox and the Greek root antho meaning man?
Sure.
I love my dictionary, and I love the indented border. Every word's in alphabetical order, ergo lost things always can be found.
And I wrap my head around the fact that in one book is the entire language of our species, which is a favorite term of Nietzsche's, who's the great-grandfather of Christina Ricci.
Yes, I joke, but the words in the dictionary are the friends that I'll have forever. More the friends I have made in school.
Philanthropy.
She's such a lovely girl with a lovely little voice.
And I heard that she's pro-choice, though still a virgin.
And she talks into her hand and often uses technique.
What you do not understand is once I say it, then I've said it.
And so much to her credit, she talks into her hand and turns aside.
So I will not make a mistake and be disqualified. Philanthropy. B-O-A-N-T-H-R-O-P-Y. Philanthropy.
That is correct.
My friend, the dictionary, is a very reliable friend. Do 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 do.
All right, next we have Miss Kaisaki.
Is it Kim Kiseki? Is that how you pronounce it correctly? Kiseki. Wonderful. Please approach the mic, dear. Watch your step, please. Thank you. Now, this lovely lady used to ride unicycles. Were you in the circus, dear?
No.
Oh, well, interesting, unusual.
Your word is bankrupt.
Could I have the language of origin?
I believe it is Dutch.
Could I have a definition?
Of course. It's the state of being hopelessly in debt.
Could I hear it used in a sentence?
Of course. Having to choose between being morally bankrupt and financially bankrupt, Philip chose moral, saying, if I have to be bankrupt, at least I want a lot of money.
Okay. B A N K R U P T?
That is correct. Next we have Mr. Chris Wolf.
Wonderful. Thank you. Apparently, Mr. Chris Wolf is obsessed with handstands. Who knew?
Mr. Wolf, your word is baragnosis.
May I have the language of origin, please?
Why, yes, of course.
I believe it's Korean.
Yes.
Let's go with Korean.
Definition, please.
It's the loss of ability to perceive weight.
Will you use it in a sentence, please?
Now that I know that you have baragnosis, honey, yes, those jeans do make you look fat.
Baragnosis. B-A-R-I-G-N-O-S-I-S. Baragnosis.
Oh, I'm very sorry. The correct spelling is B-A-R-A-G-N-O-S-I-S, baragnosis.
So close. Oh.
Goodbye. You were good, but not good enough. So please don't ask why. Simply say.
Next up, we have, yes, come around. Next up, we have Mr. Barfy.
It's pronounced Barfay.
Mr. Barfy has a rare mucous membrane disorder.
Your word is lugubrious.
Yes, of course. Lugubrious, meaning extremely sad or droopy?
More or less, yes.
A topic I am all too familiar with. One moment, please.
Okay, now watch this technique. He calls it the magic foot, and I've never seen anyone else use it before. He writes the word on the floor with his foot first to see the word before speaking it out loud. Incredible!
Lugubrious. L-U-G-U, Lugu, B-R-I-O-U-S, Lugubrious.
That is correct.
I know.
All right, next up we have Mr. Porter. Eric Porter?
Ah, he's a pro. Thank you, Eric, dear. This young man thinks barbecue sauce belongs on all foods.
So do I, actually.
Indeed.
Nothing wrong with that. Okay, your word, sir, is Mexican.
Mexican!
That's so easy!
Only the speller at the microphone is allowed to speak.
Whatever!
Can I get the language of origin?
I'm gonna go with Mexican.
Can I get the definition?
Sure. It's a resident of Mexico, or an American slang term for anybody from Puerto Rico, the Dominican Republic, South America, Spain, or Miami.
Could you use it in a sentence?
Of course. Potato chips, the Mexican lettuce.
Mexican?
That is correct. Miss Park.
Marcy Park is new to our county, having represented Virginia last year and placing 9th in nationals.
No way.
Miss Park, your word is phylactery.
Phylactery. Am I pronouncing that correctly?
Yes.
Thank you. May I have it in a sentence, please?
Either of two small square leather boxes containing religious texts traditionally worn on the left arm and head by Jewish men during morning weekday prayer.
May I have it in a sentence?
Billy, put down that phylactery. We're Catholic.
Phylactery. P-H-Y-L-A-C-T-E-R-Y. Phylactery.
That is correct. Mr. Tolentino.
Slam dunk for Park.
Hey, Marcy. Do you remember me from Nationals last year?
I only remember the top 10.
Charlito Chip Tolentino is a little league pitcher with a wicked 22-mile-an-hour screwball.
Your word is omphaloskepsis.
What? Didn't Gary Coleman's twin just get Mexican?
Yes, and you got omphaloskepsis.
But are those even rated at the same level of difficulty?
Why, yes, they are.
Omphaloskepsis. Can that also be pronounced phalloskepsis?
It can. It would be wrong.
Is omphaloskepsis the word that means contemplation of one's navel as an aid to meditation?
Oh, yes, actually, that's correct.
Omphaloskepsis. I'm full of skepsis. O-M-P-H-A-L-O-S-K-E-P-S-I-S. I'm full of skepsis.
That is correct.
Yes.
He rallies and nails it. That's what it means to be a champion.
All right, next up we have Mr. Daniel Urbanski.
Mr. Urbanski is wearing his mother's socks, apparently, and one of his ears is larger than the other one.
But he's proud of it, folks.
Indeed.
That's the important
thing.
Stand
tall, Daniel.